seen here of the fantasy basketball season, and if you got to the Final Four and the semifinals in your fantasy league, congratulations. You're obviously one game away from the championship, but here's a few guards I would look to add on the waiver wire this week, and they can help you obviously try to get to your championship. The first guy's Bruce Brown of the Brooklyn Nets. So Bruce Brown, he's been getting a lot of playing time of late, but soon reinforcements might come back for the Brooklyn Nets, and James Harden, Kevin Durant, he was available yesterday as well, but on the season, he's ranked 157th in fantasy basketball, 8.8 points a game, 5.2 rebounds, 1.6 assists a game for Brown, 73% from the foul line, and 54% from the field for Brown. But the last couple weeks, he's been playing more, like I mentioned, and the numbers obviously have gone up, ranked number 89 in the time, 11.4 points a game, 8.3 rebounds, 2 assists a game, 1.6 steals, 69% from the foul line, and 53% from the field for Brown. So Brown, he's been producing for this Net team, and he's had some big games, even though last night, like I mentioned, Durant came back and he only played 10 minutes in that game. But I still think he's worth the pickup. This Net team, they're not going to rush all these guys back right away while they're pretty comfortable up there in the Eastern Conference standings in the second seed. So the last three games for Brown, April 21st at Toronto, 21 points, 14 rebounds, an assist, a block, 2 3-pointers, and he shot 57% from the field in that one. April 23rd versus Boston, 15 points, 8 rebounds, an assist, and a 3. And last night versus the Suns, like I mentioned, he only played 10 minutes, 4 points, 1 rebound, 1 steal. So I think Brown, he's going to get back to playing some more playing time, in my opinion. And he's a player available in 62% of fantasy leagues. And even after just one bad game, he's still worth a pickup, in my opinion. The second guard's Edmund Sumner of the Indiana Pacers. So the Pacers here, they're going with a few different players now over the last few weeks of the season here while they're trying to see who can make the team next season and what the future looks like. On the season for Sumner, he's ranked 306 in fantasy basketball, 7.3 points a game, 1.8 rebounds, 1 assist a game, 80% from the foul line, and 52% from the field. But the last few weeks, and Sumner got an expanded role, he's playing good basketball, 11.5 points a game, 2.8 rebounds, 2 assists, a steal a game, a 3 a game, 77% from the foul line, and 53% from the field for Sumner. So Sumner, he's playing some big minutes of late, anywhere from 25 to 37 minutes a game. And like I said, this Pacer team, they're going to see what they got for the future. And they still got a chance to make that 10th seed or even the 8th seed for that playing game. But right now, Sumner, he's playing well. And the Pacers, they've won 3 in a row since he's got an expanded role over the last couple games. April 21st versus OKC, 10 points, 2 rebounds, an assist, a block, 2 3-pointers. April 24th versus the Pistons, 22 points, a rebound, 2 assists, a steal, a block, and 4 threes. And then last night at the Orlando Magic, 21 points, 7 rebounds, 2 assists, and a steal. So Sumner, he's putting up big numbers. He's playing big playing time right now for this Pacer team, and he's a player available in 94% of fantasy leagues. But I would go out there and get him because he's getting numbers, like I said, and he's playing a lot for this team here. And right now the Pacers, they believe in him, and they want to see what these youngsters have. The next guard's Kendrick Nunn, the Miami Heat. So Kendrick Nunn, he's been on this list a few times on and off this season. So Nunn on the season, he's ranked 98th in fantasy basketball, 14 points a game, 3.2 rebounds, 2.8 assists, a steal a game, 2.2 threes, 92% from the foul line, and 46% from the field. But the last few weeks, Kendrick Nunn, he's producing at a great rate, 16.3 points a game, 3.8 rebounds, 3.3 assists, 3.1 threes, 51% from the field, and 100% from the foul line, even though it's limited amount of free throws. But Nunn, he's back in the good gracious again here of Eric Spoelstra and this Miami Heat team over the last week, week and a half. And Nunn, for some reason, they just go away from him for a lot of parts of the season we've seen, and then they go back to him. He goes off, and then he goes back to the bench, and his value is lost again. But right now, I think the Heat should be playing Kendrick Nunn 30, 35 minutes a game like they have over the last few games. And he's producing at a good rate. April 21st at San Antonio, 9 points, 5 rebounds, 3 assists, a steal. April 23rd at the Hawks, 21 points, 2 rebounds, 2 assists, a steal, 5 three-pointers. And a couple nights ago versus the Chicago Bulls, 22 points, 5 rebounds, 2 assists, a block, and 4 threes. So none, obviously, he's a pure scorer. He's not going to get many assists. He's not going to get many rebounds. But if you need scoring, 3-point shooting, and a decent field goal percentage, none is definitely a player I would look to add on your roster this week. And he's still available in 55% of fantasy leagues. So I don't think you could go wrong with Kendrick Nunn. And right now, with him playing tonight, even though he's a game-time decision, I think he's going to play, and he's a player that should be owned in more than the 45% of leagues. The next player is Raul Nito of the Washington Wizards. So Nito, we've seen flashes of him this season, especially when Russell Westbrook, you know, sat out those back-to-backs, was banged up a little on the season. He's ranked 170th in fantasy basketball, 8.4 points a game, 2.3 rebounds, 2.2 assists, a 3 a game, 85% from the foul line, and 45% from the field for Nito. In the last couple weeks, he's ranked 123 in the time, 9 points a game, 2.6 rebounds, 2.3 assists, 1.5 steals, 1.3 threes a game, and 54% from the field. So Nito, he's going to have a good field goal percentage. He's a decent passer, and he's going to get steals as well. And while his playing time has been around 30 minutes the last 3 or 4 games, he's putting up huge numbers here for this Washington Wizard team. And he's a player producing at a good rate, and he should be owned in more leagues. And he's available in 89% of fantasy leagues. April 21st versus Golden State, 18 points, 3 rebounds, 4 assists, 3 steals, and 3 threes. April 23rd at the Thunder, 15 points, 4 rebounds, 5 assists, 2 steals, and 3 threes. And then last night versus the Cleveland Cavaliers, 14 points, a rebound, an assist, a steal, and 2 threes. So Neto, he's going to get you 3-point shooting. He's going to get you assists and steals. And he's a player that's pretty efficient for the most part this season in fantasy basketball. And he's a player I would look to get this week, especially with a 4-matchup week coming up, which is very crucial with players playing games towards the end of the season in your lineup and the 5th and final guard. I will look to add on waves this week's PJ Dozier of the Denver Nuggets. So obviously the Nuggets, the injury bug, it's hit them hard the last couple weeks with Murray tearing the ACL versus the Golden State Warriors. And then we saw last week Monty Morris go down with a hamstring injury that's going to cost them a little while. And they also signed Austin Rivers, but PJ Dozier, he's been the pickup here on the season. He's ranked 247 in fantasy basketball, 7.5 points a game, 3.8 rebounds, 1.8 assists, 63% from the foul line, and 42% from the field. But the last few weeks, since he started to play more playing time for Dozier, 11.1 points a game, 4 rebounds, 3 assists, 1.3 steals, 1.3 threes, 83% from the foul line, and 46% from the field. So Dozier right now, he's playing about 25-30 minutes a game, and he's producing pretty well here for this Denver Nugget team. And like I said, they're depleted in the backcourt with the injuries to Monty Morris and Jamal Murray, who's obviously out for the season. So right now it's down to pretty much Dozier, Campazzo, and Austin Rivers. But right now Dozier, he's taking the bull by its horns, and he's playing well. April 21st at Portland, 7.7 rebounds, 2 assists, a steal, and a block. April 23rd at the Warriors, 9 points, 2 rebounds, 5 assists, 3 steals, and a 3. And his breakout game was versus Houston a couple nights ago, 23 points, 7 rebounds, 3 assists, 2 steals, 2 blocks, and 3 three-pointers. And he played 28 minutes in that game. So Dozier, he's getting the playing time, like I mentioned. And he's helping owners in a lot of different categories. He's just not a scorer. He'll get some rebounds. He gets a lot of steals, which is also a big category and underrated. And he's even blocking shots about 1.5 a game since he got an expanded role here, is Dozier. And he's available in 77% of fantasy leagues. But right now, his ownage has jumped up 18% in the last couple nights. But right now, I will go out there and get him. And that's a few guards I will look to add on the waiver wire here in week 18 of the fantasy basketball season.